What's up guys, Sal here. So the Google Pixel 8 Pro will launch in about 4 months, and despite such a large window of time before the launch, we know quite a lot about the handset. We know how it looks thanks to Google's own official video. We even know some of its features, such as that it will have a temperature sensor to measure the body temperature. And now we have a new leak that confirms Google won't repeat the same mistake they did with the Pixel 7 Pro, and that will make a world of difference and will directly improve the user experience. You see, Google introduced the Tensor chipset a couple of years ago. It enabled Google to fully take advantage of its AI expertise to create an experience that could not have been possible with a stock Snapdragon chip. But while the AI performance of the Tensor chips was clearly superior, the CPU performance was rather uninspiring. Things got even worse with the Tensor G2 last year, where the CPU performance was generations behind the latest from Qualcomm. The main reason for it was Google's decision to use 2-generation-old cores. While the competition was using the latest Cortex X3 Prime core, Google was using the Cortex X1 core. Plus, Google was using an unusual core configuration that clearly didn't help either. But thankfully, it looks like Google has learned from its mistake. The Tensor G3 on the Pixel 8 Pro will give the Snapdragon agent on phones like the S23 Ultra a run for its money, as we have some new details about the Tensor G3 chip that reveals that Google will finally use all the latest cores for their new chipset, which is Cortex X3 for big cores, A715 for mid cores, and A510 for little cores, similar to the Snapdragon 8 Gen 2. However, there's a big difference here, and that is with the number of cores. The Snapdragon 8 Gen 2 has 8 cores, but the Tensor G3 will have 9 cores. Google is using one extra mid-core, so combined, this should make the Tensor G3 match the performance of other 2023 flagship SoCs such as the 8 Gen 2 on the S23 Ultra. Now coming to the GPU part, the chip will use Mali G715 Immortalis and will have 10 cores, and most importantly, it will have ray tracing enabled for that realistic shadows and reflections. Of course, it will also have an improved TPU for better AI tests. Also, the Pixel 8 Pro will have a new UFS 4.0 memory that is twice as fast as UFS 3.1 on the Pixel 7 Pro. This means the apps will open faster. Resource-intensive tasks such as video editing, video recording at a high frame rate, etc. will also benefit from this tech. And most importantly, it offers 46% more efficiency than UFS 3.1, which means better battery life. Moving on, the Pixel 8 appeared on wireless Qi charging certification, and it shows the Pixel 8 won't upgrade the wireless charging speed. It's gonna remain at 12 watts. Hopefully, we'll see some upgrades with this bigger brother, the Pixel 8 Pro. First, for all the latest updates on the Pixel 8 Pro, be sure to subscribe. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.